7:57. Well, I'm excited to talk to Preston and Steve about this one because we're gonna have some confessions up in here. Survey.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
You guys ready? Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So a new survey lists the things we often lie about to others. Do you guys want to confess first, or should I read some of the things we lie about?
Give us a taste.
Okay. You, what you do for a living, or how much responsibilities you have at that job.
Like, you're in charge of the whole department. I run the whole show. In fact, I'm the vice president.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
right.
We are the vice presidents of Beasley Community. Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
That's what we do. We just do this for fun.
Your travel stories or things that you've done on vacation.
I wouldn't lie about that.
No.
I want to share.
Yeah, if it's real, what do you make? Yeah, I've been to Jupiter.
Right. I mean, or you could say something didn't happen, but it actually did.
Oh, okay. All right. The problem is that we have just never lied. And that's the issue.
Yeah.
And never
teach
embellished.
Us your ways.
I think there are things that are the obvious. And I think I saw a couple on the list, like exercising. People talk about how much they exercise or their sexual prowess or things of that nature, right? Is that a common
thing? Can you really lie about exercise, though? Because, I mean, can't we see the results? That's why I feel like I have to tell the truth. Because you can tell.
Yeah, I guess to some level you could, but some people do embellish, you know?
Yeah.
I'd say I don't lie about, so as far as the work situation, but I will use work as my excuse. Like, if I don't get back to somebody, I'm like, work's been crazy.
Okay. There you go. Kathy, thank you.
Yeah.
I was trying to think of some of these things, and I'm like, wow, I'm a pretty honest person. I was thinking about this. No, I'm not. But, Kathy, that's the one I'll use. Wow, crazy busy week this week. Sorry.
Oh,
meanwhile,
sorry.
Preston's napping under his desk.
Yeah. Sorry. By the way, it's the most awesome setup Preston has under his desk. There's an actual bed.
I actually do have a bed under
my really?
Desk.
Really? Yeah. Can you send pictures? I know. You need to tweet out a picture or something. That sounds so convenient.
I'll do that. I think we've taken a video before, but I have a little yoga mat.
There's a curtain.
I put a curtain there.
Yeah.
So I can close it.
It's like a sleeping berth on a railway car. It's
oh,
awesome.
My goodness.
Yeah.
It's like George Costanza.
Like George Costanza.
Yes, Karen.
Oh, exactly. Here's one. Cooking skills. And you may not know you're lying, but...
No, Preston's actually really... I don't... In fact, I boast that I can't cook.
Yeah.
And this validates going out to eat all the time. Mm. But Kathy is even very candid. She can't cook to save her life.
I can't cook. I don't cook.
Because
I'm terrible.
The problem is if you get trapped by your own lie, because I think if you boast about cooking... If you ever have a party or whatever...
It's going to catch up with you.
Somebody might ask you to make something for them. Oh, really? Oh, that sounds delicious. Could you make that for me?
No, I was lying.
What about you guys, Alex and Karen? What are a couple of things that you're guilty of? We want to hear from you.
Yes.
Karen, you go first.
I think you're right about that. I mean,
I will, if like, kind of like you guys, I'm so busy at work, but because we have to go to bed early, Mike and I, a lot of time, we have to go to bed, you know, we can't make it, sorry. Or something along those lines. It usually does come in handy.
What time do you shoot the second show that you do, Alex?
What time? Well, that's in the evening, so I have to go to bed earlier. But I should go to bed at 8 is usually my target goal in a perfect world. Karen goes earlier than me.
I can't make it. I try to do it around 8, but I got all these kids now. They're getting bigger, and they just refuse to be like, they're like, Mom, we got to stay up to 9. All our friends are awake. What do you know? The worst mom in the world. I think sometimes there's competitiveness where you may like lie about like how great your kids are or how great your relationship is.
We talked about that. That's a big one. And I lie about how great my kids are. I don't have kids.
He's real good at it.
Or what about getting off the phone? Like, I have to go. Something's happening or someone's calling. Have you guys ever done that?
You do something. Oh, I got to get off the phone. I'm not enjoying talking to you.
Yeah. Which is not a lie.
Yeah.
Which is
not a lie.
Alex, you guys. You'll love this story. Elisa Federico, who you guys also work with, she has been my best friend since we were 15. There have been times, and she knows, she'll be in the middle of something. I don't want to cut her off, so I just hang up on her.
And then she
texts me, and she goes, I guess you had to go. Call me later.
So you've been friends long enough. So no warning, just click.
Click.
I'll have
Sorry,
to try that.
I had to go.
Oh, my wife and I have a thing where there's the hand signal where I'll go, Claire!
Yeah.
I gotta go.
Yeah.
You know, he's an idiot. He did something.
Oh, man. My best friend calls me at like 9 o'clock at night, and it's always when he's walking his dog. And I don't even lie to him about that. I go, I've used all my words for the day. I don't want to talk. I'm done.
I've used all my words for the day. That's another
yeah,
one.
Yeah, enough.
My
yeah,
sister has some drama in her life, and so she talks about herself. And then she was talking to my brother who works in compliance, and he's telling her about his day. And all of a sudden, he notices it's quiet. She fell asleep.
Yes.
That works too.
That's great. That's awesome.
Well, now I'm inspired to be more honest. So thanks, guys.
Love you guys.
Take care, guys. We'll see you later. All right.